What do you want?
We want your help, Kath.
And we're going to get it too, Kid Killer.
Help? With what?
Last night, we figured you've got to know something about Kelly's murder.
Well, I don't, honestly.
Yeah? Then what were you doing while we were all at the party?
I was here by myself.
Prove it.
I can't. I was writing.
Well, did you see anything that might help?
No. I was just minding my own business. I thought that's what you all wanted.
Start thinking! You must have seen or heard something!
Well, the officer that got attacked...
Mrs. Radcliffe.
What about her?
Well, she walked past and then a few minutes later I thought I heard a sort of a thud, that's
all. That must be when she was bashed.
Why didn't you tell me that in the first place?
I didn't think of it. I went out there, but the corridor was empty.
Now, what time was this? You've got to remember.
God, I don't know.
Well, just start thinking!
I think it was just before I heard a lot of screaming and shouting coming from the party.
That must have been us doing our act.
Yeah. I could be wrong, of course.
Oh, you ain't wrong, lady. That's my alibi you're talking about. In fact, you're so right, we're going to tell her screws right now.
He's always smoked dope. I've never minded that so much.
But he's mainlining hard and fast, and he's only a bloody kid.
No, Rigby, just come on. Look, we'll work something out.
Yeah, but I'm buggered if I know what.
Well, what about Dan?
I've thought of that. I don't reckon he'll listen to Dan anymore. He reckons he's gone soft in the head,
all
too.
Right, lady,
I'll try and sort something
come
out.
Come on, line up and shut up.
Mr. Moran, I've got a big problem.
Maybe it's not what Jenkins has got.
I need to see Dan the man.
Talk about it later.
But it's real urgent. My auntie's dying and I need him to see her to say a prayer or something. Yeah, before she pops up.
I'll speak to the governor.
But I need to see him before we go outside this afternoon.
I said I would talk to Mrs. Reynolds. Now get back against the wall. Now cut down the racket, all of you. All right, where's Patterson and Egbert?
Here, Mr. Moran.
I need to speak to the governor straight away. I've got some information about Kelly's murder.
All right, but you'll have to wait till after muster now. Just get back against the wall then. Now, come on, settle down and shut up. I won't start until this line is dead straight.
No, I didn't get much sleep. I just kept going over and over the whole damn thing.
You still angry with Dan?
No. Just disappointed. Anne Reynolds. Is he? That's fine. Thanks.
Inspector Van, coming through now.
Before he gets here, I think you should know. The women have got it into their heads it could have been Joan.
We'll try and scotch that idea.
Of course.
She was with Pat at the time of the murder and totally in the clear. Mm-hmm. For once.
Morning.
Early?
Well, they say the early bird catches the worm, don't they? Just wanted to cross-check a couple of the statements from last night before we get started.
You've got those, haven't you, Meg?
Yes.
Good. Just a bit of paperwork, and I say you can throw away the key to Patterson's cell.
Inspector Barrett, I think I should warn you that if I suspect any prejudices operating during this case, I won't hesitate to go to your superiors.
Ah, oh, come on, she's guilty as hell.
So you keep saying. Whether you can prove it or not is another matter.
I'll prove it, lady, if it takes a bloody month.
Exactly.
I'm going into town. It won't be long.
Well, you can take as long as you like. None of my business, isn't that right?
I'll be back to change for the wedding if Heather still wants to lift her friends.
Oh. Don't look at me like that, Stephen. I'll drink what I like, when I like, and where I like.
Okay. I'll mind my own business.
Governor of the prison, please.
You sure Patterson isn't pressuring you to say this?
No. Well, I mean, she pushed me into reporting it, but it's what I heard.
All right, I'll take you through to see Mrs. Reynolds.
Oh, the way that Patterson girl carried on. I mean, I didn't know it was important. I'd forgotten about it. Why do they treat people like that?
Patterson could face life for murder. If she's innocent, she'd want to prove it.
And I'd want to help her. But for God's sake, I mean, one minute they're at my throat because of Linda, and then it's because they want me to help them.
Takes a while to get used to the way things are run in a place like this.
Oh, I don't think so. I'm learning fast, Bob. I can either quiver in a corner or I can stand up for myself. And I'm not going to be kicked around by those bitches anymore.
Can't take on the whole damn prison yourself. There's some bloody tough women in here.
And I'll have to get tough too.
Kath.
You can't be here all the time, Bob. And believe me, the next person who has a go at me will get a hell of a lot more than they bargained for.
I see. Well, I'm glad you finally saw fit to let me know. It's unfortunate it's been allowed to go on this long. Excuse me. Yes?
Got a minute. Something important's come up.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Ryan. I have to go now. Obviously, I need to talk to your son as soon as possible. Yes, if you would. Thank you. Goodbye. What is it?
Maxwell says she has information on the Kelly murder.
You know who did it?
No, it's just that I've remembered something that I forgot to tell the police when they talked to me before.
You better sit down and tell me about it.
There's something I want to talk to Mrs. Morris about. Do you mind if we leave you to it for a minute?
Go right ahead. Right. Go ahead, I'm listening.
That was Steve's mother on the phone. Seems she's been worried that Wentworth isn't a fit place for her son to be working. Hearing about Kelly's murder this morning confirmed her opinion.
But surely Steve's old enough to make up his own mind.
Steve has been lying his head off to us from the word go. I've just learned the real reason he came here to work.
You realise Hookie's going to expect some bread for this nobby?
What?
The tyre.
Oh, yeah. We'll fix it later, eh?
Wouldn't have had to if you'd done what I told you.
I did. You saw that jump. It was spot on.
Except for the drop.
It wasn't my bloody fault. There was a rock there, was it?
A good rider would have checked the ground he was landing on.
There's nothing wrong with my ride. Besides, I can't check the bloody ground out at Wentworth, can I?
Guess not, but hell, man, you needn't have to wreck a perfectly good tyre when it was just a tryout, did you?
Well, who cares? Come on, grub, you're acting like an old bloody woman. The main thing is it works.
If I can fix this, maybe.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, of course you will. We're counting on you.
You could help.
Got more important things to do. Gotta get the old girl nice and shiny for Reed.
She'll be needing it tonight.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then.